Well, what are some of the more surprising results that you've seen? I know that things like the bull in the China shop just took everyone by surprise, but what are some of those really surprising results that you didn't expect?
Oh, just we did one recently. Actually, it's Damien Adams. Is the bull in the air? Nobody's recording this, right? All right. We're doing hits about guns that are kind of wacky, and they had this really cool cartoon one where, have you ever seen Yosemite Sam has, he has like a rifle and or a shotgun, and folks gonna go bend it back so it shoots him? She actually made a bent shotgun that shot the bullet all the way back. It worked. I mean, I thought there was no way this was gonna work. I thought that, you know, that it was going to explode in the barrel or something, but the bullet actually continued.
It was crazy.
That's so bizarre to me. I was watching this in one of our rock pops, and I was like, no! What?
So cartoons were real!
I know! I wanted to actually hear that, and I thought it was sort of bummed that we didn't hear that one. It was so freaking cool.
Well, speaking of cartoons were real, another one of those, like, there's no way that's gonna, you know, work. It's, Are Elephants Afraid of Mice? And Jane and I went to Africa. They had a little remote trap door that let a mouse come out around wild elephants, and the elephants lost their mind. It's a little white mouse.
Way backwards. It
freaked out. And the only thing it was missing was like the table and chair for the elephant to jump on and lift its shirt. It was just like the cartoon said. Cartoons were fine.
Speaking of cartoons, is there one thing, and let's take safety out of this because you're wanting to code the team and kids now, but if money was no object, is there one myth that you think this would be just great to test if either because of money or technology you can't right now, but just something you're dying to test?
I mean, it's a couple. We always throw around the idea that we would love to do upside down race car, but I mean, It's that a Formula One car has so much downforce that it can actually drive upside down, but we need a helical track miles and miles long, as well as a Formula One race car, which, try out the t-shirts. Nobody says $1 million car, crazy enough.
And then find somebody to drive it.
Oh, we know who's going to drive it.
I don't know who's going to drive it.
And you totally drive it.
There's one that I've always wanted to test is, going into outer space, and if your spacesuit were to open, you know, in space, would you, I guess, implode, explode? Basically, just fly to pieces. Yeah.
Okay.
Anybody want to try that one? Volunteers.
No, okay. There's one I always wanted to do, but it's too sick and morbid, and like Discovery would never do it. I always wanted to do 21 grams. We just need something to death bed.
Do you know the myth, 21 grams?
That when you die, your soul weighs 21 grams, so you instantly lose 21 grams.
That's crazy.
You never heard this one? I think there's a movie called 21 grams. So anyway, we thought of completely through. You've got, you know, got somebody on a deathbed, a volunteer, just saying, call me. We just have their bed within a scale, and then we wait for that exact moment, and we have the scale, we've got a camera, see what happens. Last breath.
Yeah.
I guess it'd be boring
just
watching
somebody sleep. Until they die. That's not morbid at all. I would say if laying the kids down a slide is
morbid. You're running me. You're running me over. That's why I'm fired too. Okay. Not an executive.
Your show has been credited with a real increase in people getting into the different STEM fields, into the science, technology, engineering, math fields. Have you seen that when you go out and speak or with anything? And what do you think the impact of the show is?
Well, people tell us that, and it's kind of mind-blowing to us because we didn't start out with an educational show or a science show. It just happened to turn out that way, that the teachers started using our shows in their classrooms to teach basic physics or you know, show how math is practical in the real world. Well, I guess our world isn't really the real world.
Really?
It was an amazing byproduct that I think we're all very happy about, and I mean, we couldn't be more pleased that this is the end result. And you know, we've tried to tailor certain things towards the educational system in the, you know, aftermath of finding out that we could be used this way. For a while, Science Channel did a thing with me where they took some Mythbusters clips and did a show called Head Rock, where we did, you know, you can do this at home experiments for kids. And, you know, we tried to reach out that way because we realized we do have this amazing product that does that.
Yeah, and I think that's kind of the easiest for me growing up as, you know, through school. The teachers that didn't teach traditionally lectures or, you know, over, you know, projector screens, where they actually had you go and do stuff, I learned more from those teachers. And, you know, especially with now Mythbusters, it's like every day we're figuring stuff out and it's learning through doing. And I think that's a much easier way to teach than trying to learn, you know, through reading, through, you know, lectures.
Memorizing the components yourself so that you can repeat those on a test and then you'll forget them 5 minutes after.
It's all memorizing and not really figuring out and actually learning. So I think that's why our show, you know, it's designed to entertain, you know, initially. And by default, we learn some stuff, and then we blow stuff up at the end. It's awesome. Everybody wins.
We all came to the sort of love of science sort of late because we didn't know that that's what we were doing. We just, all of a sudden, one day, we're like, oh my God, we're doing science? How are you a science going off? Weren't you in film school? Exactly. Jamie's got a degree in Russian, Adam's got a high school diploma, Grant's got an electrical engineering degree, which is the closest thing to qualified that any of us are for this job. You know, arts and film, like it's crazy. But the whole idea of the show is that we're just regular guys, and we're doing science because it's not something that just a nerdy guy in a white lab coat is going to do somewhere and speak in a language you don't understand. No, it's something that's accessible to everyone. So I think that's what has been a good message for us.